And we're joined by Ray. I have to buy some more banana pudding Wyatt from the Lakeland Jamboree. And Ray, you got big doings this weekend. You all are going to have a full house. You've got action tonight, and then tomorrow night, you got some special music coming our way.
Yes, we do. We have.
What are you doing? Put your phone over there.
Oh, yeah. He's texting. It off. I thought you were texting.
No, I'm turning it off.
Listen to me, honey. I'm on the radio now. Wait, no, okay. No.
Yes, we have Southern Tradition on Friday night, and then the long-awaited, if you've read our Facebook page, Instant Zeal for Saturday night for our 70s and 80s. The first time we called it Sock Hop, but that didn't really fit, so we're calling it 70s and 80s music and dance.
Let me tell you, it would be some good music, and you got a lot of dance floor room out there at the Jamboree.
Yes, we do. We rearrange the chairs and get you some dance floor, and get you some hot dogs and popcorn and
banana pudding if you
want
it.
Banana pudding. That's Friday night. Friday night only.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So we have with us Steve Shelley. Uh-huh. And he is with Instant Zeal, and I was just telling Steve, I enjoyed the music so much at the Trigg County Hospital Foundation.
Thank you, Cindy.
We had a great time, great music. You all played it all. I mean, it was a wide range of music there. So tell people, what is your style of music with Instant Zeal?
Okay, Cindy, I appreciate the comment, and it's a pleasure to be here this morning. Appreciate the opportunity. We basically do 70s and 80s classic rock, and we focus in on that. But we have a lot of great players. They're very versatile. And so we try to throw in country selections, other pieces of music that some people may enjoy. So
now, if you're a fan of Instant Zeal, what are you? A zealot? Or is like Cindy, is she a zealot? Or what do you call your fans? You know, Grateful Dead, they're called Deadheads. I didn't know if you had
I don't know what the term is.
I'm thinking a zealot. What do you think, Cindy?
Zealous.
You're resilient,
yeah,
all right.
That's good, Bill. I like that. We'll have to start
that.
We'll
work that in. Quiz. Yeah, we get it.
Okay, Cindy's now, like, they I'm were thinking, so was there five or six of you guys?
Yes, we have six people. The band. Okay. And I might mention who they are.
Yeah,
really
sure,
quick.
And what they play.
Okay. Our lead singer is Tim Moore, and Tim's from the Slaughters area. A lot of these guys,
can't claim somebody from Slaughters. I've been through; it's a pretty area.
Yes, it is.
And you get somebody from Slaughters, that's good stuff.
Don't close your eyes; you might miss it.
That good barbecue up there.
Too. I'm learning more about these towns. Being an Indiana guy, I moved down here 3 years ago, and a lot of these towns are a lot like the ones we had up in southern Indiana.
Oh yeah, exactly.
Yeah. I grew up in a little town called Degonia Springs, so Slaughters is. Right there with it.
Same category.
That's right.
Okay.
Anyway, the rest of the group here, Todd Duvall, plays drum set. He's from White Plains. We have a really talented piano, guitar, and vocalist, Alan Robertson from Madisonville. We have our bass player from White Plains. His name is Chris Rich. He's not related to Charlie.
That was my question.
But he does a great job. And on guitar from Nortonville, Danny Darnell. And I'm a saxophone player, so that makes up the Instant Zeal.
Great job, too. Great
Thank you.
Job. Okay, so where have you played? Where people might have heard you?
Okay, well, Cindy, obviously you heard us at the Blue Jean Ball.
Right.
And we had a great time. I think there were 220 people for that.
It was great.
About a year ago, I met Ray, and Ray does a fantastic job of promoting music in the area. He's got a great venue.
He does.
There at Lakeland Jamboree. We played there before. So I think that's just a tremendous thing for the community.
Yeah. You know, live music. Nothing like live music. And you know, at the Lakeland Jamboree, you can get it every Friday and Saturday night.
Yes, it's a great opportunity. It and it's a real pleasure to get the opportunity to play there. It's
and Instant Zeal is going to get a lot more exposure this summer. We have several events coming up. The Music and Food Festival in July 29th.
Yeah.
The Eclipse Festival, we've already finally got back in line on it.
All right. Nice.
And cool. So and then July will be the fifth Saturday night in July, which is Instant Zeal's night at the Jamboree. So they'll be uptown on the Justice Center parking lot like it was last year.
Okay. Yeah.
And we've got another thing coming up May the 13th, a real 50s dance that we've been working on with the whole doo-wop scene. But Instant Zeal is going to get a lot of exposure in Katy's this
year. Awesome. That's great. We'd love to hear that. Now, Steve, how did you get involved in the group? How long have you been with them? And, okay, and well, how
that's an interesting story.
Okay.
My wife and I, Kim and I, were at Kentucky Dam Village, and we were camping Memorial Day weekend, and this was actually last year. And so I'm a former high school band director. I taught at Evansville North, and I had my saxophone in the back end of my truck, and we heard the group out there performing. And I told Kim, I said, man, these guys sound really, really good. And I wonder if I can go over there. Yeah.
Did
I wonder
if
I
can
go over there and sit in. So I asked the guys, and they looked a little hesitant, you know, at me. And I said, it's okay. I kind of know what I'm doing.
I know Ray Wyatt. And they're like, oh, come on.
That's right. Yeah. They got to have connections.
Yeah.
But anyway, that's how I got started. And we've had a lot of fun with that group. A lot of great guys, great players.
All right, so Saturday night, you'll start. Do you have a playlist, or you just kind of go with a feel?
Well, we usually have practice every Tuesday and Thursday evening, mm-hmm. and we go through our set list according to who we're performing for, and we try to find out what people like. And we do tunes like Old Time Rock and Roll, Best mm-hmm. of My Love. We do the Doobie Brothers, Long Train Running. Yeah. We also have some Alabama tunes and George Jones, Merle Haggard.
All right, love
Can't
that.
Beat that.
Ooh, nice.
Got to have that at the Lakeland Jamboree.
Yeah, there you go. And he's also neighbors with Mike Wright, but mm-hmm. we shouldn't say that.
I wouldn't admit that. That would not be good.
I want to give a special shout out to Mike Wright. He is the greatest neighbor. He's the first guy I met when I moved down here to Cadiz.
And you still came.
Yes. He's a great ambassador for Cadiz.
He is a great guy.
Yes, he is.
All right, Ray, what time, Friday and Saturday night, what time do we need to be at Jefferson Street in Cadiz?
7 to 9 every time. We the first year we changed it 6 to 8 in the wintertime, and so it kept everybody confused.
Right.
So after that first year, it's 7 to 9, and that's it, except when Instant Zeal's there, they play from 7 to 10.
Ooh, oh, wow. Right. Yeah. Well, they got some stamina to that
Rolling
group.
Rolling out the streets a little longer in case.
We dance until your socks are hot and rambling.
There you go. Boy, that's a metal picture. Like the Lakeland Jamboree on Facebook. Yeah. You can see up today. Fellas, have a good show this weekend, and thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Yeah.